Hello. Sorry, I could not receive your call earlier as I was in a meeting. May I know who this is?
Hello. I'm about to kill myself.
Can you tell me where you are?
I'm in my room. I'm going to hang myself. There's nothing left for me and everything's going to end and I won't be in this pain any longer.
Okay. Can we talk about this?
There's nothing to talk about. I have no one to talk to and nobody listens to me.
I'm here. I'm listening to you. Can we talk about it? And let's work on it together? I want to help you. But you need to trust me. Will you allow me to help you?
Okay,
now close your eyes and breathe in and breathe out.
Now open your eyes. Now could you tell me why you wanted to take this drastic step?
Life has been very hard on me. I have nobody to talk to. No one cares about me.
What makes you say this, Shivani?
It's always been this way. My parents, they used to love me a lot. But now they don't even care. They always make me feel like I'm not good enough. They're always putting me down. And they're never there for me when I really need.
Okay, nice. That's good. Are you see what she's done? She's made some nice designs.
I have no time for this now.
She should try and you should let her do it.
What's the big deal if she has done good this time? Can you guarantee that she'll be doing good all the time? It's better that she concentrate on the kitchen work. That will help her.
I can only imagine what you're going through. But I assure you, I can help you to get through your difficult times.
Nobody understands my pain. Nobody can help me. I once approached a college counselor and I felt really good talking to her. But then, while I was leaving, my friends saw me leaving the counseling room. And now they think I'm mad and mentally unstable. So I stopped seeing the college counselor.
Hey, did you invite Shivani for the party tomorrow?
Shivani?
Yeah.
She's mad, yeah.
Why?
I once saw her going to the counseling room. I don't want mad people at my party.
So, I stopped seeing the college counselor. And I distanced myself from most of my friends. Now I just prefer being in my room. All alone.
Nobody deserves to be treated that way. See, we can't change the way people look at things, but we can change the way we see things.
Even my boyfriend doesn't want to see me anymore. He said that I cry and complain all the time.
I was trying to talk to my dad yesterday.
Here we go again.
What do you mean?
Can we ever talk about something normal and happy for once? All you do is talk about yourself and your problem. But what about me? And what about how I feel and my problem? I can't do this anymore. I'm done with you.
Where are you going?
He said that he can't tolerate my whining anymore. I thought that he would understand, but no. And now he started ignoring me, and that makes me feel like I don't deserve anyone's love.
Your boyfriend didn't see your worth. It's his loss. Do you think he's worthy of your love?
really, but I loved him. I loved him a lot. But he left me. He left me alone.
But maybe God has better plans for you. See, everything in life has a purpose. And now you have to find yours. So, Shivani, if we focus on your strengths, we can find a way out.
But what strengths? I'm not good enough according to my father. And I don't deserve anything.
You are good. And you deserve happiness. You said that you wanted to be a fashion designer. Wouldn't that give you happiness?
That's one thing I'm really confident about. And it's a dream that I've wanted to achieve for a long, long time. But then, I have no family support.
There is a misunderstanding between you and your parents. Maybe your parents don't understand the scope of fashion designing. Can you come and meet me at my clinic today?
Fine. I'll come.
Good. See you later, okay?
Shivani, are you okay? I got a call from the counselor. I'm so sorry I didn't receive your call. I'm so sorry. I'm here, okay? You don't worry. We'll go to the counselor together.